Good evening. I hate to interrupt such a congenial group. I'm Linda Fried. I have the deep honor of serving as the dean here at Columbia University's Mailman School of Public Health. And tonight, the equally deep honor to welcome all of you as we come together to commemorate, recognize, cheer, and inspire the future for the groundbreaking visionary work of the Columbia Children's Center for Environmental Health. I am so proud to be part of this, and I know from talking to so many people here tonight that you share my pride in what has been accomplished and what we know will be accomplished for all of our benefit. Tonight you'll hear from Columbia Center for Children's and Environmental Health visionary leader, Dr. Ricky Pereira. You'll hear from Associate Professor Dr. Julie Herbstman, and we will honor CCCEH's truly valued partners, Wendy Kelman New, Luz Towns Miranda, and Brian Lehrer. Since the Environmental Protection Agency and the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences program to jointly fund children's environmental health centers started in 1988, CCCEH, I'm having trouble pronouncing this, but I know what it is, has been one of only two continuously funded centers in the United States. Over the last 20 years, the center's research has provided the scientific basis for environmental policies that protect the most vulnerable. They have built on the pioneering, visionary, and really brilliant molecular epidemiology work created by Dr. Pereira and her colleagues, an approach that looks for clues about the causes of disease within cells and then can link those to the potential exposures in our environment that may be causing that disease within cells, and then links it to the communities that are experiencing those exposures and whose children are at risk from them. What more powerful combination can there be of science for the public good and for our collective future? Dr. Pereira herself, even before the full center that came to bloom, has been a scientific visionary and pathfinder as well as path creator. She started as a cancer researcher. I have a feeling we may hear what made her leap into the vision that she saw and created for the work that we're celebrating tonight. But she not only has been the leader who created this amazing center and its profound impact, but actually created the whole field of molecular epidemiology, which now is a foundation for scientists all over this country and around the world. And she has built partnerships that made the science deeply matter for people's lives. I can say that I was talking to Peggy Shepherd before, and when I came here as dean a little over 10 years ago, I think the first event I was invited to was WEAC's honoring of Ricky Pereira for then already many years of sustained partnership in bringing the issues of the community into science and science to serve the community. The center is built on this pioneering molecular epidemiologic science, and it is unique in the wide spectrum of environmental risks and exposures and outcomes they study, from asthma to neurodevelopment to children's IQs to obesity to cancer risk and many other critical issues of exposures that set children up either for risk and future ill health or for health itself. They always consider the social context in their work, with a focus on urban minority populations who have been traditionally underrepresented in scientific studies and are the most vulnerable and most underserved in terms of protection. I personally couldn't be more proud to be a member of this community with all of you and to be here tonight to recognize the work that Ricky started, the work that all of the collaborators and investigators who are here tonight have come together over 20 years to bring to fruition, and we'll be hearing from many of them. And I think it's a special moment to reflect on the tremendous impact that they have made on improving the health and well-being of children in all of our communities. Now I'd like to welcome Dr. Andrea Baccarelli to the podium to tell us more about Columbia Children's Center for Environmental Health and to introduce other speakers for this evening. I'm proud to say that Dr. Baccarelli is the chair of our Department of Environmental Health Sciences, as well as himself being the director of the Laboratory of Precision Environmental Bioscientists. He's an epigeneticist and a board-certified clinical endocrinologist, and he currently is the leader, the principal investigator, of multiple National Institutes of Health-funded projects. His research explores potential pathways, very in concert with CCCEH, that link environmental pollutants and their exposures to, and how they affect human beings to human disease. Andrea.